This meeting today concept name is dynamic handling file system concept. Dynamic handling file system. What do you mean by dynamic handling file system? Before going to dynamic handling file system, first of all, we should know what is flat file. What is flat file? Flat file means it doesn't have any predefined format. That is called flat file. It doesn't have any predefined format. That is called flat file. Example, notepad, comma, text document. Doesn't have any predefined format. Whatever you want, you can write it. There is no restrictions like characters, you can write it, special symbols, you can write it. Continuously, it will take. So it will not come to next line. So continuously, if you write 1 year also, it will take continuously. So that is called flat file. It doesn't have any predefined format. Today, concept name is file system. What do you mean by file system? Definition. If you want to create a new file in file system, comma, if you want to create a new file in file system, comma, if you want to write the data into the file, in file system, file in file system, if you want to read the data or get the data, so we can use anyone. If you want to read the data from If you want to read the data from file in file system, we will use file system concept. Right. If you want to create a new file in file system, if you want to write the data into the file in file system, if you want to get the data from file in file system, we will use file system concept. Directly, we can create a new file in file system, we can write the data into the file system, we can read the data from file system, we will use file system concept. So, Arvind Venkatar. So, today concept to dynamic handling file system concept, sir. Today concept name is dynamic handling file system. Before going to dynamic handling file system, we should know what is flat file. Flat file means it doesn't have any predefined format like notepad, text document. So there is no format. Whatever you want, you can write it. There is no restrictions. So that's the reason we are calling it is a flat file. Okay. Today concept is file system concept. What is file system concept? Through code, without going to D drive or E drive or F drive, through code, we can create a new file in file system. We can write the data into the file in file system. We can get the data from file in file system. We will use file system concept. Without going to anywhere, so through code, we can create a new file in system and we can write the data into the system. We can get the data from system. So that is the concept of dynamic handling file system concept. Without going to D or E or anywhere, so we can create a file, we can write the data into the file, we can get the data from file, we will use file system concept. For that we are using five predefined classes. One is file, we can create a file. File writer, we can write the data into the file using file. Five predefined classes: file, file writer, buffered writer, File reader, buffer reader. You can use this five predefined classes. File reader, buffer reader. If you want to create a new file in file system, if you want to get the data from file in file system, if you want if you want to create a new file in file system, if you want to write the data into the file system, if you want to get the data from file system, we will use this five predefined classes. File, file reader, buffer reader. We are using these five predefined classes. Right. Where exactly we will use? Using file, we can create a new file. File writer, we can write the data into the file. If we write only file writer, we are unable to write the data into the file. Compulsory, we should take the buffer writer reference, then only we can able to write the data into the file system. Only for this logic purpose we are learning concept. So if you write only file writer, we unable to write the data into the file system. Compulsory, we should take the reference from buffer writer, then only we can able to write the data into the file system. Right. Next, file reader, we can read the data from file system. If you write only file reader, we unable to read the data from file system. Compulsory, we should take the reference from buffer reader, then only we can able to read the data from file system. Buffer reader is used for we can read the data from file system. So only use file reader, we can't read the data from file system. Buffer reader, compulsory, we should write buffer reader, then only we can able to read the data from file system. That is the concept of dynamic file system concept. Right. How we can use, I will tell you. This is your last class, exception handling. Today concept name file system concept. Go to src, take the new class. Class name is file. Take spell mistake. Already file is a predefined class. So take the spell mistake. Keep the mark publish static void menu. Click on finish. So now I want to create a new file in file system. How to create the file in file system? File reference name f equal to new file, file f equal to new file, class name reference name equal to new class name, file f equal to new file. I'm giving the path where I want exactly in the d colon. I have name with 9 a.m. dot txt. I want to create this file in file system or my system. I want to create a file in file system. F dot create new file. Without this line also it will create the file, but this optional. Without this option also we can create a new file in file system. Right. File writer fw equal to new file writer, give the path bug. Only if you write file writer, we are unable to write the data into the file system. Compulsory, we should take the reference from buffer reader, buffered reader br equal to new oh No, buffer writer. We need to write buffer writer. Buffered writer. Buffer writer FR equal to new buffer writer. FW file letter reference FW, right? Next line. So if you want write anything, we should take buffer writer reference only. BW dot write Happy New Year advanced. B next new line, BW dot new line. Right. Buffer writer BW method. Right. Next, write something. BW dot write. It will bring you a lot of joy. Right. Import the statements. Already these are predefined classes. Java.io file writer. Java.io. File writer java.io. Buffer writer java.io. After writing code, so compulsor we should write flush bw dot flush. Flush compulsor we should write flush, then only it can save the data or it can hold the data, otherwise it cannot hold the data. So compulsor we should write flush. After writing the code, so add throws declaration io exception. Just we need to add one exception, throws. Yesterday already told you, so without throws, see how many exceptions is there. 1 2 3 4 5 6 exceptions at a time. Just keep the cursor on any underline. Just add throws declaration io exception, right? Like we can create a file in d colon and we can write the data into the d colon. Happy New Year, it will bring a lot of joy. Save, run it, go and check it. Nine a.m. Happy New Year, it will bring a lot of joy. Like we can create a file in file system, we can write the data into the file in file system concept over. Next, I don't want to go every time d colon, I want to read the data. So then file reader fr equal to new file reader. Next, file reader fr equal new file reader, buffer reader br equal to new buffer reader fr. Same logic. Only if you write file reader, we can't read the data from file system, or we unable to read the data from file system. Compressor, we should take the reference from buffer reader. So that's the reason here I'm writing buffer reader, file reader, java.io. Buffered reader. Buffered reader. Right. Now, what is the use of Boolean? We learned one of the data type Boolean. What is the use of Boolean? It will give true or false. So data is there or not, I want to check. Data is there or not, I want to check. So then we can use Boolean. Boolean. Data is there or not, it will check. If it is data there, it will give true, otherwise it will give false. Boolean b equal to, here is, these two lines are not important. If you want, you can write it, otherwise you can't. No need to write. So in future there is no chance to implement Boolean. So here we have some scope, like if it is data is there, then it will give true, otherwise it will give false. Boolean b equal br dot ready. Ready method is used for data is there or not, it will check. If it is data there, then it will give return. SYSO control space B. So if it is data there, it will give true. Yes, data is there. Happy New Year. And as well as I will, it will bring you a lot of joy. So true it is giving. So these two lines are not important. I don't want to make confused. I don't want to waste your time, but still this is also sometimes it will helpful. So that's the reason I'm saying here two lines is not important. Okay, right. I want to read the data. So how we can read the data? Write the while loop first. Where exactly we will use while loop? Already told you. So how many fixed number of times so that loop should be executed? If you know that figure or number, that time we will use for loop. So here is boolean. Sorry, while is as long as condition being satisfied. There is no restrictions like 10 times, 20 times. So how many lines of data is there? I don't know. So that's the reason. If you write boolean, then it will execute all the first to end. Boolean, br dot ready, br dot ready. So if it is any for loop or while loop, compulsory we should start with curly bracket. Take one string, store in one string. I'm writing string. String s equal to br dot read line. So I'm saying, oh god. String s equal to br dot readline. SYSO control space s. So it will read it. So I'm saying to Selenium, sorry, Java. If it is data there, then it will give true. Okay. If it is data there, just print it. While br equal to read line, br dot read ready. So store in one string, string s equal to br dot read line, system dot out dot print line. Yes, print it. No need to go D drive. So from here only we can see true. Happy New Year. It will bring a lot of joy. See, this is the concept of dynamic handling file system concept. It is very easy concept, a simple concept, but you should remember